Elementor just released four new features, one for the free version, three for the paid version. In this video, I'm going to show you what they all are and how they work. I'm happy you're here. Now let's get started. The first new feature we're looking at today is the ability to add and or filters to the taxonomy filters in the WooCommerce grid loop. And if that sounded like a giant word salad, it definitely was. Hopefully seeing it will help it make more sense. And this feature is one of the ones for the pro version.
So in this template here, we have our loop grid here showing our products. And up here, we have the taxonomy filter widget. This is where you allow people to filter and sort your products based on what they click on in this bar up here. In this case, it's set to product categories. Under the settings, we can now choose multiple selection. And we can choose a logical combination of and or. So if someone were to click on men and shoes, it will show only products that appear in both of those categories. If you choose the or combination, it'll show products, all the products that appear in men and all the products that appear in shoes. So that's the difference between those two. To turn this on, it's actually not by default inside your taxonomy filter. You have to go into the WordPress dashboard, go to the Elementor menu, click on settings, then click on features, and then scroll down until you find taxonomy filter. You have to change this to active. By default, it's set to inactive. And once you have that set to active, click on save, and that's going to appear inside of your WooCommerce editor. And you also note this feature is currently in alpha. That means it's brand new. Beta is a feature that's pretty good. There's probably still some bugs. People are still testing it. They're trying to tweak it and fine tune it. Like beta is this one right here. That's the status a feature gets before it's released, just before it's released. Alpha is like a brand new feature. It's barely workable, and we just want to get it out there and see how it is and get feedback and stuff like that. And I'll show you why it's barely workable. So out here, if I click on men and shoes, you can see they're both a darker black compared to the other ones. You could have your CSS and your styling set to that it's more, so it's more prominent that you have both selected. We see one pair of shoes. If I now click on shoes over here, it now shows there's nothing there, which makes sense because there's nothing that is in all those categories all at once. There's no indication of that. There's no message saying you picked all these categories and there's nothing in all these categories all at once. For your user experience, it's not completely clear what's happening when you use the taxonomy filter. If we change this to or and update, let's click on men and shoes again. We had one shoe earlier. Click on men and shoes. And now we have three products. These are the products that appear in the men category or the shoes category. You can add packs and gear, and you just keep adding more categories. And again, a customer, a visitor, might not know exactly what's going on here. Because the default functionality, which makes a lot more sense, which I think is like how our brains work, the default, you click on a category and it shows what's in that category. And only what's in that category. And that makes sense intuitively. Whereas the and or is super useful, but there needs to be some kind of indicator that you're doing that for a user experience, in my opinion. So I can see why this feature is in alpha. Hopefully it gets improved. It is super useful. This needs to be a little clearer how it works.
The second feature we're looking at is the ability to add custom messages when the grid loop doesn't have any products to display. It's a pretty minor update, but it's still pretty important for user experience. And this one is also for the pro version. If you want to upgrade to the pro version, there's a link in the description down below. It is an affiliate link. If you click through that and purchase, I will get a credit for that from Elementor, but it does not make it more expensive for you, and it helps to keep making these videos. So if you buy through that link, I really appreciate it. Now let's check out what this custom message update is all about.
So the custom message you actually saw a moment ago when I was clicking through the different categories and we couldn't find a result. If you click on the loop grid and go to additional options, the nothing found message needs to be turned on here. This is the new feature, and this is the message that displays. So this appears when we're clicking around, and let's do men and shoes and shoes. There's nothing in there. This is the sentence that displays, which is the sentence we have written here. And this can include links, this can include pictures, this can include whatever you have to do to help your customers realize that there's no products here, they should choose a different category. So that's pretty useful. It's not a huge feature update, but it's still pretty useful.
The third new feature we're looking at today is for email attachments. Now when you build a form in Elementor, you can have attachments not just added with a link in the email and the attachment saved in the server, you can have the attachment sent directly along with the message into your email inbox, saving you server space. This is also a pro version update. Let's check it out.
If we investigate this form widget right here, we see we have a choose file button right here to upload. That's been around for a while, where it uploaded content directly to your server and then sent you a link via email. Now if we click into this upload, let's actually show you how to add it first. You could go to add item, from type you choose file upload, and that'll give you the file upload dialog box. We got a second one here now. Delete that because we're going to use the one we have, or look at the one we have. We have in here the option to email with attachment. Previously it was email with link. That was the only option. I don't even know if there's a drop down here because there was only one option. Now it's email with attachment, email with both a link and an attachment. So when you use the email with attachment, the file is not saved on your server. It's sent only to your email address. If you choose link, the file is saved on your hosting server and then you're sent to link, which takes up your server space. You might not want to do that. So it's not a major feature update, but anybody who's spending a lot of time cleaning up all the attachments that are arriving on their server and keeping it all organized and managing it, this could be pretty helpful.
The fourth and final update we're looking at today is the Elements Manager. This is a brand new section inside of the Elementor plugin inside WordPress and allows you to turn Elementor widgets on and off depending on what you're using. And when you turn widgets off that you're not using, it's going to make the editor work a whole lot faster. That is, if you're turning off a lot of them. If you just keep them all on because you use all of them, it won't be any faster. But if you turn a bunch off, it will be a whole lot faster. Let's see how it works.
To find the Element Manager, you go to the WordPress dashboard, go to the Elementor menu, click on Element Manager, and we're on the page right now. We see all the elements that are available inside the Elementor editor. You'll recognize these as these that are listed here. And why is this important? Here you can turn them off. So let's say you never ever use Meta. You can just turn that off. And that helps your Elementor page builder be a whole lot faster. It's not going to affect the front end very much of your page load speeds. It's going to affect when you're working in the back end. Now the trouble is, when you're going through this list, you might want to turn a bunch of these off, but you don't know if you're using these or not, because if you turn it off and it's actually being used on a page, it's going to break the page. So they've added this fancy button called Scan Element Usage. Click on that, and it's going to look up how many times elements are used, sort them by usage, headings, we've used 51 times, image box 31, divider 17. You can read through the rest. There aren't that many here. It even shows us which plugin is providing these. These top ones are all Elementor free. This one's WP Forms Lite. This one's from Elementor Pro. This one's from a third-party add-on by the same people that make Astra, the theme, ultimate add-ons for Elementor. And so it shows you everybody's plugins and things that you're using to create your pages and the widgets they're using. And all the rest, you can just turn off, and that's gonna make your grid over here with all the widgets so much less cluttered.
And don't forget, if you wanna upgrade to Elementor Pro, use the link down below. If you wanna subscribe to my channel for more videos like this, have at it. We'd love to have you in the community. Also click the bell button so you don't miss any future videos. And next up, check out this playlist right over here, which is all about Elementor Pro and improving your Elementor Pro skills. And then check out this playlist right here, which is all about speeding up your WordPress site. My name is Bjorn from WP Learning Lab. Till next time, keep crushing it, and I will see you in the next video.